What's up, Buck fans? We're back again for another film study. Today's 46-23 Buccaneer victory over the Carolina Panthers. Let's talk about that defense. They held them to 23. They had glimpses of where they were really good, where they shut them down. The first half wasn't it, but let's talk about all the good first. This is a team defense working together. Plus, I'll let you break this down a little bit. What'd you see?
Right, yeah, this is like an inverted cover two look that they're going to present here. Again, you see all that, you know, bodies up front there at the line of scrimmage. It looks like they're going to bring some pressure, but really it's just a rotation of guys getting into a zone, and really they're rushing four, and it does a great job of causing confusion for Teddy Bridgewater, and then JPP just makes a nice play here on the football, getting into his spot. You see Teddy, he's throwing to the guy that's running on the curl route at the top of the screen, kind of like a little in, and he just never sees JPP right there, makes a great catch, and it's a great play. But you can see all the moving parts there. It's really nice. And you're creating, you know, havoc there up front with that because guys don't know who to block. So,
yeah, and you can only see, like, you see how everyone's almost doing a little spin. Like, everyone's going off to the next guy, right? It's cool to see that. And then Jamel Dean getting in on pressure, forcing a bad decision. He ended up getting hit. JPP catches it with eight fingers and gets down. I love the celebration. JPP so goofy. Well, let's keep going on. Now it's JPP sack. Just watch William Golson, too, is when we run this back. William Golson's practicing some spin moves here. Love that little move right here in the inside, which causes all this havoc in the inside. Bridgewater has to step up. JPP has enough time to get back after the play. He gets injured on this play, but good hustle play by JPP. What'd you see?
Yeah, this is a good job by the front four, you know, causing some pressure. Again, a guy went in a one-on-one, and William Golston doing a good job here. Just nice spin move. You like to see that. You want to see him get lowered there with his pad level. He probably wins there and gets the sack, but good job by JPP finishing up. You know, Bridgewater, like you said, had to loop to the left. So, yeah, really nice. Here, bringing pressure. This is what we need to do often. You know, we talk about this constantly in the live stream. You know, bringing those A-gap blitzes, you create one-on-ones for others, and it leaves guys like Anthony Nelson open here, as you're going to see. The left tackle doesn't know who to cover. So it's like, okay, we got Sean Murphy Bunting coming from the corner. That creates opportunities for guys. You like to see Nelson finish, obviously.
Everyone.
But it's really good, and it creates a quick pass here by Teddy, and it causes incompletion. So that's our defense in a nutshell. That's what you want to see more often.
You live and die by this, pretty much. If you're going to bring pressure, bring pressure. You can't be passive, especially a team that lives and dies off of it. So, and then, yeah, I see him crying like a baby. I should have had that pick. But we're going to show this more and more often. This is what we didn't do against the Saints, which we did do frequently against Carolina Panthers. And with this, again, there's more pressure coming in. Look at all these damn guys. They're ready to hunt. And then what I love the most, check out Antoine Winfield. It looks like he's on the tight end over here. He realizes he's not going out for a route. So he pretty much just comes over here and sits. And that's where the only option for Teddy Bridgewater to throw is. But he can't make the throw because Antoine Winfield's sitting in his zone. He's like, okay, well, my man's not going out. I'll sit here and get in the way. Incomplete pass. They wanted a flag. It wasn't. But what'd you like?
Yeah, you nailed it. It's great awareness by Winfield. Just seeing that his guy is in there to block. They're running max protection. Does a good job of dropping back into that zone, taking away that pass. And you just like everybody's working here together. You know, everyone's got a man. Pretty much everyone's locked up. So that's really nice to see.
So Jamel Dean has been getting picked on a little bit as of late, but this one he actually did pretty well. So you see, again, we like this little really close to the line. They do a really nice pick play, but Jamel Dean's right on him, sticks with him, hugs the corner over here. As he's going around, you see the little pick coming around, really gets into the body of that wide receiver, and he's so damn big, puts his arm up, knocks that thing down. What'd you see?
Yeah, this, again, playing team defense. You know, I like the pressure that they're trying to create up front, the chaos with the stunts and everyone moving parts, but just good communication and Jamel Dean being able to, you know, catch up and make the play, get in the way of the football. It's a really good job. Here, again, reverse angle, as you'll – we see here again running stunts, you know, Devin White coming in, causing havoc. Good job there by Dean, just being in position though. And the other two corners are in position with their guys. So good job just picking everyone up.
you know, not picking up a flag either. He's just getting his hands in the way of the ball, pretty much. He doesn't know where it's coming, but he saw the receiver's hands go up, and he just knocks that thing down. Real heady play. And then look at all this again. Oh, hell, I got to get rid of this ball quick. They're coming at me. What do they actually do? They draw back. So the illusion of pressure, too. This is stuff. Just keep doing it. It's working. Don't change. Don't outthink yourself. They always do this. This is when they lose. But what'd you say?
Yeah, I like this too because, you know, it's a good job of, like you said, creating the illusion of pressure. Again, this is like a third. I believe this is a third and short situation, mm-hmm. but a good job of creating that. And they're still covering the sticks, as you see there. So they're going to let, you know, Robbie Anderson catch this ball in front of them. And then you go make the tackle. And this is what, you know, the Bucs defense of old did way back when, you know, in the late 90s, early 2000s. That's how they played defense.
The bend but don't break mentality, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now let's check out, why are we so good in the run game? We always got to add one of these at least. Nacho, watch him push the center back. Immediately blowing up the play. Curtis Samuel has nowhere to go. Devin White and company come in. Help make the tackle for Nacho over here. Really love it. That's why we're in top five in the run. But we always add one of these, it seems like, every week, too. Devin White's insane grip strength. Tell me more about it.
Crazy. I mean, the gap integrity is definitely very good. It was much better in the second half of this game. You know, the Carolina was getting some runs early, but, yeah, this is just crazy by Devin White making that play. And, yeah, it does seem like it's once-a-week thing now. So, just really good job. Now we're going to get into some of the negatives. Again, just being a little bit aggressive on coverage, you know. Play action works here. Guys getting a little bit too antsy. You know, Jamel Dean, you want to see him stay back if that it truly is his guy, or, you know, the safety, you know, late getting over. But it looks like Jamel Dean was at fault there. Just got to stay with him.
Yeah. I mean,
but again, that's a good play design by Carolina. They set it up well.
They had a couple of really good play designs. But this is what we mean by live and die by the pass rush. Look at, it's a big play. No, don't get me wrong. But look what had to happen to Teddy Bridgewater for this big play to happen. He gets knocked on his butt, just gets it out on time. It's just a great move. I mean, this is a good double move by the corner or by the wide receiver on the bottom of your screen. It's a nice little double move. I could be going in. Nope, going up. Colton Davis just gets beat. But look at this. Putting on his ass. So you got to give him credit. But this is the stuff. Don't give them time to read it. Force the decision. I mean, this is just a lofted ball. I mean, if it's lofted a little less, that's an interception. What do you think?
Definitely. And this is what we always talk about. It's just, this is your identity. Continue to play with that. This had to be a perfect throw for this to be completed. And it was. But I like the aggression. I like the look. You know, you're blitzing JPP from the middle linebacker position. So you're presenting something different. He gets a hit on the quarterback. And this is just a really good play. I mean, obviously, Teddy knows what the play is. He's expecting double move here on the outside. And it's just really good execution. Carlton just eat a little bit, and it's a perfect pass. But again, like you said, we can live with that.
And this, you know, play, here,
this was well designed.
Yeah, very well designed. I'll let you break it down more. Just again, this is something we're gonna have to watch out for Monday night against the Rams. I'll let you touch on it more.
Right. Yeah, this is a good concept because you have the motion across, so you already have like the defense flowing one way. You know, Antoine Winfield sees that, you know, Sean Murphy Bunting is going to follow Curtis Samuel. So he's already going in for the blitz. Like, he's coming in on the pressure. He's thinking he's going to, you know, create the backside hit there and maybe force a bad decision. But this was the play the whole way. And they had it set up perfectly because, you know, you have the advantage with your, you know, blockers. And then that's just easy touchdown. So good job. You know, if you're going to defend this play, you got to have number 43 come up right away and attack number 12. If you know Antoine Winfield is coming in, that's got to be the play. But again, great execution. It wins most of the time.
And this was the play right after that deep pass. Carl Davis got hurt. So I can understand why they'd want to attack him, but not like this. Damn near killed the guy. But other than that, yeah. Be aware of this for Monday night, guys. Hope you enjoyed the film breakdown as always. If you haven't yet, hit that like button, subscribe down below, comment your thoughts. And with that said, until the next one.